In this lecture, we will cover variable mass and the rocket propulsion. Few things one has to keep in mind in such problems is that we solve it in terms of time at a given time t and take another frame at t plus dt. So initially mass of rocket be at time t be m and let the velocity be v, and at t plus dt let a small exhaust which is small dm, please note it is small dm, has come out. Since this small dm has come out, the mass of rocket will be m minus small dm. Don't write it as m minus capital Dm, it would be wrong. It is m minus small dm, please keep in mind, otherwise you will get a negative sign in the final solution which will not be the correct result. So it is m minus small dm because small dm has come out. And the velocity at this point of time be v plus dv. Let u be the velocity of the mass with respect to rocket. This is with respect to rocket. And rocket was moving at this point, at this time, with velocity v plus dv. So the upward velocity of the exhaust will be v plus dv minus the velocity with which it has come out of the rocket in opposite direction. So it is u. We assume that no external force is acting, so the momentum is conserved. So momentum here is mv will be equal to final momentum is m minus dm, this is small dm, please note, v plus dv plus dm mass of exhaust into v plus dv minus u. So this is the momentum of exhaust, this momentum of rocket at time t plus dt, and this is at time t. We solve it, we get mv is equal to mv plus mdv minus dmv minus dmdv plus dmv plus dmdv minus udm. This gets cancelled, so we get mdv is equal to udm. This is small dm and this is capital M. So we have to have in the same form. Now let us write the relationship of change of mass of rocket and the exhaust. We know the mass of rocket is decreasing and this is the mass of exhaust which is increasing. They are equal. So dm upon dt will be equal to minus dm upon dt or minus lambda. If lambda is dm upon dt, because this is decreasing, so that is why it is minus. So dm upon dt would be equal to minus lambda. So replace dm by this, dm small dm is equal to minus capital dm. So we write here m dv is equal to minus u dm. So dv upon u is equal to minus dm upon m, and integrated, this is constant, it's not variable, so we can write dv is equal to u minus dm upon m. Let m initial be mi and let this be m final at any given time t. And velocity initial be 0, this is velocity final. So velocity final would be equal to minus u ln log m final upon m initial. You can see the m final is always less than m initial. So it will be, and you can reverse it. You can write minus sign you take there. So u log m initial upon m final. So this will always be greater than 0. This will be positive. It will be positive, sorry. So V final would be equal to U log M initial upon M final. So this is the relationship of the velocity of rocket, presuming the initial velocity was 0. If we take the initial velocity as VI, then it will be V final minus VI. Like that. So this is just a simple form. for rocket propulsion.